Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and this Google Analytics guide, you're going to learn about the 10 most important reports when it comes to understanding how to turn all those website visitors into happy paying customers. Timestamps below, along with some other helpful videos to getting Google Analytics installed and running some paid traffic campaigns. So if you don't already have Google Analytics installed, that's okay. This is going to help you a lot. And then I'll link up in the cards in the description to a video that walks you through how to install it on your site. So when it comes to Google Analytics, there's only three questions you really have to be asking yourself for these 10 reports to answer. The first one, of course, is where is your traffic coming from? The second one is who are they? And number three is what are they doing once they get to your site? So those are the three questions we're going to answer using our 10 reports. And of course, the first thing we want to do is look at where is our traffic coming from? This is arguably the most important and the most powerful feature of Google Analytics. And to answer this question, we're going to be using the Source Medium report. Then we're also going to be using campaigns. Now, campaigns do require something called UTM. Don't worry, I'll show you how to set that up because it's one of the first things you should do once you have Google Analytics installed on your site. But for this, we're going to be using our acquisition report to look at all traffic by source medium and then, of course, by campaign. So let's go ahead, jump right into Google Analytics here. The first thing you're going to do once you get to your homepage here is go to acquisition and then click on all traffic source medium. So this is going to be our first stop. So what we're looking at here is a breakdown of where all of our traffic from across the world has come from. So if we take a little look here, you'll see source is where the traffic came from, the specific website or social media platform. Whereas medium is the type of traffic. So medium could be something like organic or referral. So let's go ahead and take a little bit of a deeper dive on medium. So medium tells you information about how someone got to your site. So for example, if you're running Facebook ads, you want to know the difference between someone clicking on an organic Facebook post versus someone clicking on an ad. And so that's what medium does because they both come from Facebook or they both come from Google, but we want to know, was it paid for? Did affiliate do it? Was it some sort of campaign or promotion? And so that's what medium tells us. And this is really, really important because we can start to compare how our posts and content does organically versus our paid advertising or our affiliate promotions do. And so that's all there is to it, to medium and source. So going back to medium and source here, you can actually take this a step further and go over to all campaigns. And then we're going to go ahead and scroll down here and you'll be able to see all of your campaigns by name. Now we'll go through how to set this up in a moment. I just want to show you the power of setting up UTM parameters and creating your own campaigns. So what we're looking at right here with these campaigns is everything that's being promoted under the sun in one easy to read dashboard. So whether we're doing YouTube ads, Facebook ads, Pinterest ads, Twitter ads, LinkedIn ads, all of that information can be put right here so you can see how whatever product or service you're promoting is doing across all of your platforms. So to do that, we'd come up here to secondary dimension and then we would click on acquisition and then we'd be able to sort by source and medium. Now, if you're a little confused here, that's okay. Give it another 90 seconds, it's gonna make perfect sense. So then what we can also do is click on advertising and we can see how our campaigns are doing by the keywords that we're bidding on or by the exact ad or blog post that's being promoted. Now, what's really cool is if we went ahead and clicked on campaign content, all of a sudden, we're going to be able to see the exact ad, blog post, video that's driving traffic to our site and which product or service it's promoting. Now, this is only possible if you use something called UTM parameters, which is how you set all of this up. So we're going to transition into how to set up UTM parameters, and then we'll come back to this report. I just want to show you this first because this is arguably the most powerful part of Google Analytics. So chances are you've been browsing the web and you've seen some URL like this where there's a bunch of random text after it and you go, how is a URL that long? Like what is going on here? Well, they're using something called UTM parameters, which is what allows us to create the report that you were just looking at. So if we broke this down a little more, you could see that there are actually different sections, UTM source, medium, campaign, content. So I hope it's starting to come together. That's exactly what we're looking at in the analytics report. So if we take a deeper dive here, you can see that we can tell it what the source of the traffic is, what medium it is, so are we paying for it? Is it organic? Is it someone else promoting us? what the campaign name is, and then of course the keyword, which I generally don't recommend using, and then the content code itself, what specific ad, blog post, or video. So essentially what you would do is every time you want to post an ad or you want to promote a page on your website, you would use a free tool to create this URL. And then when someone clicks on that URL, instead of Google Analytics just saying, oh, it came from Facebook, all of a sudden you're telling Google Analytics all this extra information so that inside of your dashboard, you can see information on your specific post or video. So to do this, all you need to do is head over to Google, just search UTM Builder or DuckDuckGo or whatever else you like to use, right? And then click on the first result, Campaign Builder. So if you come over here to the Campaign Builder, I'm going to go through this a little briefly. I'll link up in the cards in the description. There's a full 20-minute video that goes through a super deep dive on how to set all this up, right? So all you do is come into this and you'd start by typing in your original website URL. So this is the URL that you would have shared, right? So let's say we're promoting one of our products, right? And we're linking people over to our product page. Well, instead of taking that raw product page link and just pasting it everywhere under the sun, we would come to this tool. So let's say we're selling our UTM builder, right? So actmarketing.io/UTM builder, and that's the sales page. Actually, don't go to that because it's made up, right? But let's just say that's the product that we're selling. Well, let's say we're promoting it on YouTube. So we'd go ahead and type in campaign source YouTube. What type of campaign, what's the campaign medium? Let's say we're just doing it in a normal video like this. We're not paying to promote the video, so we just type in organic. Well, what's the campaign name? I highly recommend just using the campaign name to represent whatever product or service that you are promoting. That way it's standard across all of your different platforms. And then campaign term, let's say it's Google Analytics. And what's the campaign content? Let's just say the video is internally coded M150, right? And then we can copy this URL and paste it in the description box of our YouTube video. So now every time someone clicks on that link, it tells Google Analytics it is from YouTube, it was organic, we didn't pay for it, it is for the UTM campaign, it's selling the UTM product, and the campaign term is Google Analytics, which is what the video was about, and then this specific video was M150. And we get all of that information instantaneously just because we took this little extra step. So if we go back over to our report here, let's say we're going to go ahead and take a look at the first campaign. So I want to show you how powerful this is. Let's click through and see what ads or what videos or blog posts are doing the best promoting one of our offers here, the sales funnel template. So if I click on the sales funnel template, it'll take me back to source medium, which isn't going to help very much because we're only promoting on YouTube. But if we were doing this on YouTube, Facebook, Pinterest, Instagram, Google Ads, all of those would be listed here and we would be able to see side-by-side comparisons exactly how these different traffic sources are performing. Here, I'm gonna go into ads because I actually have some data to show you. So we'll go ahead and click on secondary dimension. I went to advertising ad content and now I can see all of the individual videos and how many times the link in the description box was clicked. So if you're a fellow nerd like me, hopefully this is just crazy cool, right? Because now we can actually start to analyze what types of videos or blog posts or ads are getting more clicks, are getting more opt-ins if you set up conversion tracking, which is a little bit advanced, so I'll link to a video later on that will go through how to do that. And when you're analyzing, we can go in and see, okay, what is different about video M15 that got us so many clicks versus all the other ones, right? And what's really cool is that this doesn't care what platform it came from, right? So let's say for example, just for example purposes, M115 was on YouTube, and then M12 was Facebook, and B41 was LinkedIn. Well, we can easily see in one dashboard that M15 on YouTube did the best, right? So then we can go create more content like M15 for the other platforms where our other posts didn't do as well, or vice versa. So if this is still a little confusing, go ahead and comment in the comment section below because I still read and reply to every single one. I'm starting off with this. I know it sounds complex, but once you get the hang of this, this is the arguably, the most, I have to say arguably because I know some other people disagree, But for me, I think this is the most powerful tool you have at your disposal when it comes to Google Analytics, because you can literally see exactly how your content and ads and different traffic sources are performing in one easy to read report. So that does it for acquisition. The next step, of course, is once they're on your website, is learning about who has actually clicked all of those links, right? So this is going to be who is your ideal customer. And for this, we're going to look at age and gender reports, and then we're going to look at interests and locations. So let's go ahead and jump back into Google Analytics, and we'll start with age and gender. So we'll go ahead and click on audience this time, and then we'll click on demographics, and we just need to click overview. Now, when you click to overview, if you haven't already enabled it, you're going to see something like this. So right after you're done watching this video, this is the first thing to do before you set up UTM parameters. So do this and then UTM. I know it kind of wasn't in order, but UTM was important. Yeah, that's okay. So go ahead, make sure you enable this, because by default, it is not enabled. By the way, every time you create a new view, which is an advanced thing you can do, you also need to make sure that you enable this. This is not turned on automatically, and no, Google Analytics is not retroactive. So if you haven't turned this on, it's not collecting any data, right? Luckily, we have for this, so I'm going to switch over to what it would look like if you had already enabled it. And the first thing I need to note is the percentage of users. Google's doing their creepy tracking thing. They're watching what most people are doing on the internet, but they're only at about 40 to 50% most of the time. So this data is going to be 40 to 50% of all of your users. So this isn't 100% accurate, right? So use this data as a suggestion as opposed to set in stone, right? And so you can use this information to better understand who's clicking on your links, and of course with your advertising as well. That's about as complex and all the insight you're going to get out of these two reports, right? So if we go on down to interests and overview, this is going to be helpful if you're running things on the Google Ads network. So this is going to be search, this is going to be Gmail, this is going to be display, and this is going to be YouTube, and I'm sure there's one I'm forgetting, right? So anything Google Ads related, these audiences you can actually target inside of Google Ads. If you're not using Google Ads or you don't plan on using Google Ads, then go ahead and skip this because it's not going to be helpful. And just remember to keep in mind that this is not all of your users, right? You can see here it's still only 40, 46% of the total website users. So don't take this as set in stone if you're using Google Ads. So just because you use one of these doesn't mean your Google Ads is going to knock it out of the park, right? So the final one here with understanding who your website visitors are, we can go ahead and go to geo and location. And this is where it gets a little creepy, but the good news is it is anonymous, so don't freak out too much. I've had some weird comments in the past about it, like, oh my gosh, they know where I am. No, not really, not you specifically, but in general, right? So we can go ahead and scroll down here and see how our website traffic is dispersed across the globe. And then what we can also do is actually take a deeper dive on specific countries, states, or provinces. So if we go back over to the top here, let's say we want to learn more about the United States. So we can click on the US, and then you can mouse around and start to see your traffic numbers by state. And then let's say you've gone through all the states and you go, hey, I want to know more about California for some reason, right? So we can go ahead and click on California, and all of a sudden we can start seeing down to the actual cities and areas where we're getting the most amount of clicks and traffic. Now, for local-based businesses, this is really, really important because it's going to help you better understand where locally your customers are. Now, you can't go down to zip codes and neighborhoods because, well, that would probably be a little too much information. But don't worry, because even though Google Analytics is tracking everything we do, it is all anonymous. So it's not like someone who has a website will be able to figure out that you exactly where you live, or you, and just like you won't be able to figure out where people who are visiting your site live. So hopefully that doesn't creep you out too much and that information is actually helpful. So that does it for the reports you can use to figure out who your website visitors are. So finally, we have what are they doing? And so this is going to be where we're going to be looking at behavior flow, page engagement, and bounces. So we just want to understand, what are people doing once they come to our site? What pages are working? What pages aren't working? So we'll go back over to Google Analytics here, click on behavior, and then click on behavior flow. Now this is really sweet because you can actually see how people progress through your site. So you can see what pages most people normally land on when they first come to your site, and then you can see the sequential pages. So you can start to better understand how your site's user experience is good and where it might be falling short. So for example, if someone comes to your site and they immediately are going to the search function, well, that probably means that your site links aren't really helping them find what they actually want, right? So you can actually click on all of these different green squares to see detailed information about the individual pages. But what I want to call your attention to is the very first start. So this you can change based upon the landing page, so the first page they hit, or the source, or even the campaign. So if we come up to the settings here, you can change it to campaign, source, or landing page. Here, I'm going to change it to source so we can see how different traffic sources affect what people do on the website. Now, it might look a little confusing because it's hard to follow those flows, but you can actually click just for one traffic source and see the flow of traffic. So for example, we can see here that YouTube and direct are the most. Now, when you see direct, forgot to mention this earlier, that just means Google Analytics doesn't know, right? So that's where UTM parameters comes in to shorten the amount of direct traffic that you have, because chances are people aren't really just literally typing in your website name. Direct is more just Google Analytics doesn't know where the traffic came from. So this is a really, really powerful tool. Just play with it. It's not something that's scientific. You just click through and you'll start to, after 15, 20 minutes, start to really begin to understand how people are behaving on your site. Now, when it comes to specific pages, we're going to come over to the left-hand side again, and we're going to go to site content and content drill down. So here, we're going to be able to see the most visited pages and how they perform against each other. So to do that, we're going to go over to the right-hand side and click on this tiny little box here, and then we're going to get a nice little graph showing us a comparison percentage. So we'll click on the little down arrow here and then go to bounce rate. So essentially what we're doing here is we're looking at, on given the average bounce rate for our entire site, is this page, does this page have a high bounce rate or does it have a low bounce rate? So red is bad here. So we'll see the first two are actually below average for our bounce rate, whereas the next two are high. So what we'd want to do is we'd want to go to those pages and try and figure out, why is someone bouncing? Now, all a bounce rate is when someone goes to a page and then immediately leaves. So they essentially bounce. They don't really wait for the page to fully load, or they're there for less than a couple of seconds. So what Google Analytics is telling us is someone clicks a link, sees the page and goes, that's not what I wanted, and then leaves. Well, that's not what we want to have happen on our site, right? So looking at these pages, we go through number 3 and number 4 and try and figure out, where are people coming from? So we can go source, medium, and see where the traffic's coming from, and then try and figure out, why are people unhappy when they're coming to these pages? And so we can start to improve our site performance, because we can hopefully figure out why people don't like these pages. And so that does it for the 10 reports and 3 big questions you need to ask when going through Google Analytics. So make sure you hit that like button, subscribe for more deep dive marketing tutorials just like this one. And now that you're done with this video, make sure you check out that link in the cards and the description to the video that walks you through how to set up your UTM parameters. That's going to be day number 1, once Analytics is installed, get UTM parameters up so you can start using those acquisition reports, because all the other reports we talked about, they're already there. They're already working. They're already collecting data. But the UTM and the acquisition report, UTM and acquisition, that's not being recorded right now. So you want to get that set up as quickly as possible. So thank you so much for watching. Comment below with your questions. And as always, keep building the business you love.